championship fight between Jose Aldo and Max Holloway. Well, if he is not the greatest UFC featherweight champion in the promotion's history, he is certainly on the short list. That 13-fight winning streak that he put together at 145 pounds, likely something, DC, that will never be duplicated in this division.
Yes, it'll be very tough because it's such a tough division. The guys that he had to beat in order to go on a 13-fight win streak was unbelievable. It was unreal to see the names on that list that Max Holloway beat. But the crowning moment was when he beat Jose Aldo twice to win and keep his UFC featherweight championship. And then he only topped that in the destruction of Brian Ortega. Max Holloway is one of the best fighters, if not the best fighter 145 pounds has ever seen.
And with respect to Jose Aldo, Conor McGregor, and anybody else, the UFC featherweight record books read like Max Holloway's Wikipedia page. We'll see if he can add to that total here tonight. Well, how about the pop as the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC featherweight champion works his way to the octagon here tonight? Yet another title defense is what's in front of him. He is healthy. He is ready to prove that all the featherweights below him are just that, below him for a reason. He believes he is the champion for a reason. He believes he should be mentioned with the all-time greats. And that is what is at stake for him here tonight. Another title defense, another chance to prove that he is one of the greatest 145-pound fighters this octagon has ever hosted. And now our tale of the tape for this featherweight championship fight. Holloway is 28, Aldo is 33. He will have a 1-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the particulars. He is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Bergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC featherweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer holding a professional record of 21 wins, 6 losses. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 145 pounds, fighting out of Waianae, Hawaii, presenting the challenger, Max Blessed Holloway. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer, holding a professional record of 28 wins. 7 losses. He stands 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 145 pounds, fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC featherweight champion of the world, Jose Aldo Jr.
They touch him up and we are underway.
Yes.
All right, here we go. Round one, arguably the two greatest featherweights of all time, Jose Aldo versus Max Holloway. Of course, the first two meetings went to Max Holloway, but Aldo believes he made some mistakes that he can shore up here and get the W tonight.
It's mental. He feels that mentally he was not where he needed to beat Max Holloway, but now he feels he has that all ready to come out in this fight and come out victorious.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the toe. Nice kick.
Just a slip there. Oh, beautiful combination there from Max Holloway. The Blessed Express firmly on the track tonight, DC.
Once he's rolling, Max Holloway is a real problem. And right now, he's got everything working for him.
Oh, nice connection by him there with the right hand.
The right hand is the dominant hand, and you can see how well he throws it.
Oh, he's bleeding from his eyebrow. That shot cut him. Oh, a little single collar tie there.
When you're in the clinch, you can pull down on the head and land these beautiful punches to the head. He loaded up there on that high kick.
Oh! Switching stances here. Oh, he lands a huge knee to the body. That's a crippling shot there. Goes in and secures the takedown. 2 minutes now to go in the round. Back to the feet now. He blocks the punch. Able to land there with the straight left. Oh, that is a nasty inside leg kick, DC.
It is a great technique, but it only takes one time to check it.
Right.
And your night can be over. Or you get it up like Anderson Silva. Be careful.
Got an issue? Here's a tissue. So just over 20 total strikes have landed. Oh, that is a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed upright.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing shows and talks to your toughness. Notice the drive. Look at how they drive the knee right into the midsection. Oh, nice high kick.
And he connects there with a punch, so pretty good striking display by him thus far.
He throws everything so straight and so accurate. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
That lead left hand has been a weapon for him all night. 10 seconds to go in the round. Oh, Superman punch!
Wait, let's go. Screen, screen, screen.
Let's check out some of the action now from that previous round, and he really kept finding a home for those kicks.
Yeah, and why would you change it? If your opponent is not going to check, if he's gonna stand there, and he's not on his toes, and he's stationary, you keep driving those kicks into his thighs, into his body, until he makes some sort of adjustment.
All right, here we go. As our next round gets underway, his strong leg packs so much power that even when he doesn't throw it full throttle, you see he's able to inflict damage. We'll see if he can keep it going here in this.
He doesn't throw it full power, but even when he faints it, he draws out reactions from his opponents because they don't want to get hit with any more of those kicks. It's a sight to behold.
Oh, and he lands another leg kick there. He's already landed several in this round, and the damage is really starting to take its toll.
Yeah, it's really starting to take its toll. And you watch the opponent. He's walking gingerly on his leg. And one big tell that you're starting to really do well with your leg kicks is when your opponent starts to switch stances.
Right.
Watch for a stance switch very soon.
So we call on the numbers here. 40 total strikes have landed for Max Blessed Holloway. And just 42% accuracy in terms of the land rate against Jose Aldo. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Holloway's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one? You can really limit the mobility of your opponent with those leg kicks.
Oh, spinning back fist. He didn't telegraph that one at all. All right, so he's landed some good shots tonight, but this is not a combo meal, right? No three-piece, no soda. It's one and done more often than not.
John, don't you come to me without a combo. I want the whole platter. Give him the whole platter, young man. Put some punches together. Make this guy take the whole thing. Give him more than one strike. You have now found a set of punch. The jab is landing consistently. Find something that's going to go behind it.
Muay Thai plump. Just over 2 minutes now to go in round two.
Big power punch land. Now we get back to range.
Good work there on the feet by Max Holloway. We'll see if he can close the show now.
Max Holloway's looking to finish.
Thus far, how's his opponent still standing?
I mean, I have no idea. This fight is supposed to be over. And it might not be over now, but it's gotta be over very soon.
Back to the feet. Oh, just misses with the kick.
Right hand punch from the clinch. Another punch to the head. He's really turning every part of himself into those strikes to the head.
Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself in the pocket.
Oh! Oh, look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. And the horn sounds on round two. All right, the round is over. Gut check time for him now. You see the cut on his cheek has gotten really, really bad. And even though it's not affecting his vision, if it gets any worse, the doctor will be called in. And I can assure you, he's going to have no choice but to stop this fight. Here we go, third round of this championship fight.
Look at how he turns his hips into that leg kick.
And he's looking for that left hand, just missed. Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. Holloway gets stung by that leg kick. 70 total strikes have landed for Max Holloway. And striking at a 40% clip tonight thus far against Jose Aldo. Well, it's one thing to have length, it's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Aldo. Oh, collar tie. Slips the punch. Just over 3 minutes to go in round three. Oh, nice slip to avoid that right hand. Well, we wondered earlier why there weren't as many body strikes. He's making up for lost time here. Shot to the body connects, and that bears watching. That's going to hurt this opponent.
That was a thudding leg kick. Look at him whip his hip into that kick. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Aldo's cut is only getting worse, making a nice donation to the canvas tonight.
Nice straight punch.
Aldo's kick blocked.
Nice leg kick.
And both guys really throwing with authority. Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Trying to hammer that lead leg.
Big kick land.
Oh, shot to the body connects there. He hasn't really thrown too many body strikes.
Oh! Oh! To throw at the exact... He's hurt bad, John. He's got a pressure. He's got to go chase that finish down there.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie here.
These are bad.
I mean, he's cutting them down to size with these beautiful.
So a huge round for him there. That head kick probably would have had me out for good. The guy survives to see another round.
Yeah, but he'll go back to that. It landed so perfectly. He set it up great. He did a great job of mixing up the target early, going up high, and getting the desired result.
All right, here we go. Fourth round of a possible five. And this is the time where fighters are really tested, right? Dig deep, lean on the heart. We'll see who has the upper. Oh! Huge right hand!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
And another big kick from...
That was crazy!
Wow!
It's over. It's over.
Right there is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter here tonight. Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot that ended his opponent's night.
So by way of knockout, he gets it done tonight. There is the UFC featherweight champion, all smiles, no surprise there. Gets it done in a big way tonight as he wins the belt by way of knockout.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 34 seconds of round number four. Declaring the winner by knockout and new.
So there he is, the new UFC featherweight champion. Kind of looks like the after party has already started in the octagon. I know you'll be there shortly.
I mean, it's going to be a great night. Look, I wasn't on his...